Okay, so I know most of you came here to hear one number, and I'm going to tell you the one number you think you want to hear at the beginning of this video. So, how much money did YouTube pay me in 2020? $2,403.81. Sort of. Hey guys, it's Olivia and I'm back with another video. So, I've been seeing a lot of people make this video, however, a whole bunch of people started making this video before 2020 was over. And it's like, I get it. You want to be one of the first people to make the video. But how are you going to be one of the first people to make the video when you're just going to make it completely inaccurately because your 2020 earnings haven't even come in yet? So the day that I am filming this is January 1st, 2021, which means that I now know all of my revenue from 2020. So that's what we're going to talk about in this week's video. But before we get into this week's video, be sure to subscribe to my channel because I make new videos every Monday. I make anywhere from YouTube related videos like this to rant videos to Uber Eats videos. And with all that being said, let's get into this week's video. So at the very beginning of this video, I said that I told you the number that you thought you wanted to hear. You think that you want me to go into my analytics, go over to the revenue tab, click 2020, and then just tell you the number, okay, video done. There is so much more money to be made on YouTube. And we're gonna talk about all of it. Okay, so here we are on my YouTube analytics. And as you can see, I'm on the revenue tab, it's set to 2020, and it says that I have made $2,403.81. But we're not just going to talk about straight YouTube ad revenue, we are going to talk about the other ways that YouTube can make you money indirectly. If you have an audience, you can take that audience and drive it to other places and therefore use your YouTube audience to make money outside of YouTube. And I'm going to include that revenue in this video. But let's start with the plain old YouTube ad revenue. So as you can see here, I'm on my revenue tab. The date range is set from January 1st to December 31st, 2020, and I made $2,403.81. So if there's 12 months in a year, that averages about $200 a month. There were some months when I made $300 and other months where I made $100, but in the end, it pretty much evened out to exactly $200 a month. So if we want to look month to month, we can go to my channel overview. And so if we start here, this was January 2020, I made $88.73, $98.72, $117.98, $114.16, $154.91, $169.32, $198.24, $243.19, $328.07, $344.99, and then it started to decline, $278.25, and $267.24. So that is the breakdown monthly for the total of $2,403.81. And just for a little bit more information, I got 597,077 views. I got 35,933.1 watch hours and 4,012 subscribers. As you can see, all of my percentages are up 125%, up 153%, up 118%, and up 147%. So for the year, all of my stats went up, and I currently sit at 6,674 subscribers. So what other money have I made from YouTube? Well, I have another channel. So if we go over to my classical music channel, you will see that I wasn't monetized for majority of the year. I didn't get monetized until the 11th of August. And so from August 11th to December 31st, I made $387.20. And you can see that my percentage is up 999% because the year prior I wasn't monetized at all. So even if I had made $1, it would have gone up 1,000% because it's more than zero. So then if we go to the overview of this channel, starting in August, which is when I got monetized, I made $44.96, $86.72, $87.07, $84.47, and $83.99. So with this channel, I did decline by a few dollars in November and December, but on my main channel, I declined by a little bit more. This channel has stayed pretty much steady, and the reason why I made about half the revenue in August is because I was only monetized for half of August. And another thing I want to point out with this channel, you see this bubble right here? The number in this bubble represents how many times you uploaded in that month. So this was the month of May, and I uploaded 3 videos on the 22nd, 24th, and 28th. On my classical music channel, I don't really have a schedule. I just upload whenever I upload. And so as you can see, I didn't upload in May, but I still managed to get the subscribers and the watch time by August. And since getting monetized on this channel, I haven't uploaded a video. As you can see, under these months, there are no bubbles because I didn't upload. And I still managed to make about $80 a month without uploading any videos. Granted, I have over 300 videos on this channel, so there is a lot of content for people to watch, but YouTube can literally be passive income because I made nearly $400 and I didn't even upload a video. So yes, I have uploaded on this channel for years. I started uploading on this channel in December of 2014. So I do have 6 years worth of videos on this channel. And now those 6 years worth of videos are just working for me because I haven't uploaded a video since May 2020 and I still made over $80 a month. So if you want to look at the overview of this channel for the year, it got 342,869 views. But if I change the date range to just before I got monetized, I got 213,198 views between January 1st and August 10th. So the first 200,000 views that I got this year on this channel weren't even monetized, and as you can see, my revenue was zero. So only 129,671 of those views were monetized. But then if we just go back to the year, I got 342,869 views, 4,371.1 watch hours, 767 subscribers, and then $387.20. And as you can see, all of my percentages are up 41%, up 42%, up 48%, and up 999%, because before I was making no money, and this channel has 2,045 subscribers. So then if we add the amount of money I made from my main channel and the amount of money I made from my classical music channel, I made $2,791.01 from YouTube ad revenue in 2020. But now we're going to move on to other forms of revenue. So we're going to move on to affiliate marketing. I was a part of 3 affiliate/referral programs in 2020, and we're going to put them in order of what made me the least amount of money to what made me the most amount of money. So for my classical music channel, I am an affiliate of this website called Sheet Music Plus, where if people want to buy the sheet music for the song that they listened to on the channel, then I have a link to someone who has the sheet music on that website, and then they can pay for it, get a digital download, and then they can print it themselves, and now they have the sheet music, right? So if we go to Sheet Music Plus, I made, and this is not a big number, but I made $6.16 from selling sheet music. It's not a lot, but it's something. I'm gonna put a little asterisk beside that because you don't get paid out until you get $20. So I have not seen that $6.16 other than on my computer screen because it hasn't gone to my PayPal and therefore hasn't gone to my bank account because I need $13.84 before I see the money. However, that money is real money, and when I make that other $13.84, I will see it at some point. Then we're going to move over to an affiliate program that pretty much everyone has heard about, and whenever people are telling you to diversify your income, they always talk about this. We're going to move over to Amazon affiliates, where I made a lot more money than $6.16. So if we go over to Amazon affiliates, for the year of 2020, I made $553.36. So $542.36 of that was from commissions, so products that I was linking, and $11 was from bounties, which is people signing up for Amazon products. So if we go over to bounties, you can see that in April, somebody signed up for Amazon Music. In August, somebody signed up for Audible. And in October, somebody signed up for Prime Gaming. And I earned $3 for the first one, $5 for the second one, and $3 for the third one, which is the total of $11. So if somebody clicks one of your affiliate links and then they happen to sign up for one of the Amazon subscriptions, you get a kickback of that as well. But obviously that is the small amount of money in comparison to what you make from linking products, which for me was $542.36. So if you want to look at the breakdown month to month, I made $20.53 in January, $28.66 in February, $68.66 in March, then $29.20, $40.18, $35.88, $66.59, $50.66, $72.12, $43.90, $35.13, and $47.85. Which then adds to the $542.36, and then when you add it to the 11, you get the $553.36. I got 41,730 clicks, and those are all from YouTube because those are the only places I've ever shared these affiliate links. You can share them on your website or on your other socials. You could share it on your Twitter, on your Facebook, on Pinterest. You can share your links wherever, but I have only shared them on YouTube, so I know that all the stats on this page are from YouTube because those are the only places I've shared these links. And these are from my main channel, not from my classical music channel. So I've gotten 41,730 clicks, 1,001 orders were placed, 958 of those shipped because people can cancel orders, 143 of those were returned. So when somebody returns an item, you lose the money you earned for that item. So if you earned $2 and then someone returns it, well, then you lost the $2. So this is the money after the subtractions. So after subtractions, I've made $553.36. My conversion rate, which is the number of orders divided by the number of clicks, is 2.4%. And this is how much money Amazon made. Amazon made $15,511.92 from the things that I linked, right? And I got a small percentage of that. And honestly, I'm content because I'm not over on Amazon selling a physical product and then someone orders it and then I have to package it and ship it to them. I literally just copy and paste the link. So yes, Amazon made way more money on these items than I did, but they have to like actually ship stuff. I get to sleep and make money. So yeah. So yes, that is how much money I have earned from Amazon in 2020. $553.36. And the last thing I want to talk about, I have to go over to my phone for this one. As I said at the beginning of this video, I make videos about YouTube related things and I do rant videos and I also do Uber Eats videos. So I am an Uber Eats driver. I started driving for Uber Eats in March of this year. And if you are a driver, you get a referral code and you can refer other people to be drivers. And if they complete a certain amount of trips, then you get a bonus for referring them. So for some reason, it won't show up on Uber.com on my computer, but it does show up within the Uber app. So if I go over to the Uber app and go to my earnings and such, so currently I have completed 8 referrals. I still have 19 referrals pending, meaning those are 11 more people who could complete their trips, but they haven't yet. So from the 8 people who have actually completed their trips from Uber, I have earned $1,820 in referrals in 2020. So I told you before, I made $2,791.01 from YouTube ad revenue. And then from affiliate marketing slash referrals, I have made $2,379.52 for a total 2020 earnings from YouTube plus traffic that I've sent from YouTube. My total earnings for 2020 is $5,170.53. So at the beginning of this video, I said, oh, I made $2,400 from my main channel, which is the number you thought you wanted to hear, but it's not, because if you have multiple channels, well, then you can make more money. If you use the traffic from your channels to forward them somewhere else, for my classical music channel, I forward to sheet music because that makes sense for the videos I make. For my main channel, if I talk about a product, if I talk about my subscribe pillow that I held up at the beginning of the video, I could link to that because it's relevant, and then I could make money from that. If I link to the camera that I use, because maybe you're interested in the camera or maybe you're interested in the lens, then that's relevant to this channel. Don't link things that are irrelevant. Like if you have a music channel, don't link to resistance bands for sports, because that's not what your audience wants. If people are listening to classical music, maybe they also play, so they want sheet music. If you have a channel where you show your face and you talk about different products, well, if someone is watching a video about that product, then maybe they'd want to buy it, right? So don't just randomly, mindlessly link things, but link things that are actually relevant to what your audience would like, and then you can take the eyes that you already have, and in that way, you can double dip. It's like, yes, I made money from you as a viewer watching the ads on this video, but then if you check the links in my description, and then you buy one of the products that I've linked, well, now I've earned money off of my viewer twice. I made almost $2,800 from ad revenue and almost $2,400 from affiliate marketing. So I almost doubled my money by redirecting my traffic from my channels to other places. So yes, the dollar amount that I actually made from my work online through YouTube and through my traffic from YouTube is $5,170.53. And is it a whole bunch? No. Across my channels, I probably have about 8,600 subscribers, 6,600 on this channel and 2,000 on the other channel. So about 8,600 combined, and I've made $2,800 just through ad revenue, which isn't a whole lot of money. It's not enough for me to move out of my parents' house. It's not enough for me to drop out of school and and go full-time online. Of course not. But it's still extra money. Like, as I said, I'm an Uber driver. I made more money from Uber than I did from YouTube. However, I've pretty much reached the peak of earning potential on Uber. Like, I would probably make about $1,000 a week on Uber, right? Which is like the peak of the amount of money you can make on Uber. But that's not the peak of the amount of money you can make on YouTube or the peak of the amount of money you can make online. So it's like, I'm already at the peak of Uber. There's no more up from where I currently am. However, there is farther for me to go with this whole online thing, with my different social media platforms and such. I'm still growing and there's so much farther to go. I haven't hit the ceiling of making money online. And so I'm happy that I even make something, and I know that there's so much more to make. So currently, the amount of money I made on YouTube, I could make that in 3 weeks doing Uber. And I have. But that's the peak of Uber. This is not the peak of YouTube. This is not the peak of affiliate marketing. I have so much more to learn and so many more videos to post and so many things I want to share. And I have barely scraped the surface. However, I've already begun to diversify my income, and if I was like, no, I'm not going to do affiliate marketing, I'm not going to link Amazon links in my description, I'm not going to make YouTube videos about Uber, I'm strictly going to drive for them, I'm not going to share my referral link on my YouTube channel, only when I make Uber videos. Like, I don't just share it. Like, if I'm making a video about this pillow, I don't also put my Uber link in the description because that doesn't make sense. But it's like, if I was just like, no, I'm only going to make money from YouTube ad revenue, I would have lost out on almost 50% of my potential online income. So yes, the amount of money YouTube paid me is just $2,800, but I include the amount of money that my YouTube platform has been able to give me within my total, because without YouTube, I wouldn't have been able to redirect people to these other things. So the amount of money YouTube paid me, to me, that definition doesn't end at ad revenue. It also includes the other opportunities I was able to get through YouTube. And so yes, in 2020, from all my YouTube related things, YouTube traffic related, YouTube ad revenue related, I made $5,170.53 in 2020. So that's all for this week's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I've been watching a fair amount of these videos, but as I said, all of them made theirs before 2020 was over. So I feel like mine is maybe the most accurate one you've seen to date. So yes, that is all for this week's video. My first video of 2021. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you think your friends will enjoy it, be sure to share it with them. All my social media links will be down below in case you want to follow me on there. Be sure to subscribe to my channel because I make new videos every Monday, and I'll see you next Monday with a new video.